Students, today we are going to learn about generation of computers and input and output devices of the computer. Do you know what is generation of computer means? Generation of computers refer to the state of improvement of computer technology is given on your first chapter. Okay, there are mainly five generations of computer. The first is first generation of computer. The first generation computers were very big in size, slow to work and expensive in cost. This generation began approximately in the year 1942. The technology used in the first generation computers were vacuum tubes. They were very big and very slow. The cost was very high and they had a great limitations. Vacuum tubes emitted a lot of heat and as a result, the machine heated very soon and needed coolers or ACs to cool down. Next is the second generation computers. In 1947, Bell Laboratories invented transistors which function like vacuum tubes. These transistors were faster, reliable, smaller and cheaper. They replaced vacuum tubes. They are smaller than the first generation computer, higher than first generation computers. Their storage were increased and they cost less than the first generation computer. The example of second generation computers are IBM 700, IBM 1401 and Atlas. The next is third generation computers. Transistors played a tremendous role in the development of computers, but due to its limitations, integrated circuits were invented. Number of transistors could be replaced on a single chip. Means transistors were replaced by this kind of chip. They were very smaller. Their speed was much higher than the second generation computer. Their storage were increased more by the second generation computers. They have a high reliability and they have no limitations. Their language was used very high level languages. Okay, these computers were relatively more durable and reliable. The examples of third generation computers is IBM 360, IBM 370 and ICL 1900. The next is fourth generation computer. Fourth generation, we are living in this generation computers and we are using this type of computers. These are very smaller in size, their speed is very fast, they have a very high storage capacity and they are very low cost. Okay, the examples of this generation computer are IBM 4300, ICE 2900. Okay, the fifth generation computers are which we call future computers have millions of transistors built on a single chip and they are yet to come into the market. So you can say these generation computers work very fast than the previous generation computers. The next topic is input and output devices. As you have learned on your previous class about the input devices, today we are going to revise some input devices. They are keyboard, scanner, digital camera, mouse, light pen, joystick and touch screen, which we call also a screen mirror. Output devices, they are monitor, plotter, LCD, speakers and printers. Students, all of you know about the input devices and their functions. The first is keyboard. It is a text-based input device that allows the user to enter letters, numbers and other characters. It consists a set of keys known as alphanumeric keyboard function keys, enter, space bar, backspace, delete, insert, shift, etc. The next is mouse. The mouse is a small device used to point to a particular place on the screen and select in order to perform one or more actions. It can be used to select menu commands, size, windows, start programs, etc. There are three buttons on a mouse: left click button and right click button and a scroll wheel. The next input device is joystick, which is usually used to play games. Next is a scanner. Scanner is also an input device used for direct data entry from the source document into the computer system. It converts the document image into digital form so that it can be fed into the computer. Monitor. Monitor is an output device that resembles the television screen and uses a CRT display information. CRT means cathode ray tube. The monitor is associated with the keyboard for manual input characters and displays the results on the screen. The next is printer. Printer is also an output device which is used to print the images given by the computer on a paper. There are many types of printers which will be learned in your next class. So students, keep learning your book. Learn the questions given on your worksheet. That's all for today. Stay home, stay safe. Bye.